Though I didn't know it then, I was about to discover that being a teenager was a privilege only the unfortunate few could ever really understand.
It's me again. I'll be over after the exam. It starts at 3:30, but Winters is doing a revision class, so I'm going in for that now. Make sure you text me when you're done. I love you. Bye. Looking back on the track, gonna do it my way. Looking back.
Hello?
Mr. Temby, it's Martin Cardle here.
Ah, hello, Mr. Cardle. How are you?
I've just had a call from Bridget from the church. There was a break-in last night.
Oh, my goodness. Was anyone hurt?
No, just some minor damage, vandalism. The insurance people are in there now. Anyway, long story short, I'm going to have to postpone today's meeting.
I was wondering, would you be able to call round the committee and let everyone know?
Well, perhaps I... Hello?
Hello?
Can you hear me now?
Yes, I can now.
Perhaps I could host the meeting in my house.
Yours?
Well, it is my day off. It would be an honour. I'd bake.
Well, I've got a few things to sort out for Youth Week. Look, I tell you what, can I leave it to you to let everyone know? And perhaps we could push it back a few hours to give people enough time.
Well, how does 2:30 sound to you?
That would work.
Start preparing, huh?
I'll see you then. Thank you.
My pleasure.
Mr. Cardle, I'd just like to say my prayers are with William.
Well, God bless you.
Goodbye.
Oh. Oh, no.
No, 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 not today!
I thought you were at the hospital.
How did you get in?
The spare key. I thought I'd drop off a few more DVDs when he gets back.
You also thought it would be okay to break into my house.
We finished early. How come? Are you okay?
Well, I have to leave in 10 minutes, so Luke will have to go, okay? Yeah, drink that.
No. Tomorrow is too late. I need someone by 2:30. No, 3:00 is after 2:30. I do not care who it is. Just send someone. Anyone. Thank you.
I brought you Dexter. Thought you were revising. Do you want this? Did he finish West Wing?
Not yet. Some kids broke into the church last night. That's why he's in a mood.
Kelly wrote she's pregnant again. She's not going to know who the father is until it comes out black or white.
What's the matter? Tired.
Remember when I married Kelly Roach in infants? I could stay forever.
What are you doing?
Did they take it out?
What?
Where's it gone?
Nowhere, what?
Will, you're freaking me out now.
The doctors think that we'd be better if I stayed at home from now on.
What? Why?
They just do.
So you'll be having treatment at home?
No.
I don't get it. Why would they tell you now to stay at home when you've already started the block?
I haven't.
Haven't what? What are you talking about?
They said any more chemo or radiotherapy would be toxic. I've had too much.
But Will, you've already started the block. You have already started.
No, I didn't. They never put the new line in.
What happens now?
You okay?
I need to go to school.
Luke!
I'm fine.
know they've stopped this treatment. I'm talking to you. You can't let them do this.
Look, I know you're upset, but we must put our faith in the Lord and be strong.
This is your idea.
What?
Is that what you think this is? Atoning for his sins?
We're all sinners, Luke.
Just some more than most.
I have accepted will, and so will Jesus Christ.
Hate the sin, not the sinner. Is that what you're trying to say?
Don't do this.
No, don't you do this. You're his dad. This is sick. I'm going to be sick.
You don't understand.
Yes, I do. And I ain't going to let it happen.
Road, and you take
I need to see a doctor.
Do you have an appointment?
Oh, no.
Just one second. Haven Lane, I've never heard of it. Is there anyone there that you...
Can I see a doctor, please?
Are you registered with us?
No.
Well, you'll need to be registered for... No, not you. To get you a form.
Cherry, have you seen my address book?
No.
I'm here for the washing machine.
Oh, I telephoned for a plumber.
I am the plumber. Hello. Shall I?
Oh. It's not just your van that needs cleaning.
As I say, it's not something I can discuss.
But if he's not getting treatment, he's just getting iller. Can't you just talk to me?
But the team at the Royal Orthopaedic are among the best in the country.
Yeah, real lifesavers.
So what happened?
Ewing sarcoma, bone cancer. A day before his 13th birthday.
To your finger?
I caught it in a door.
Well, I don't think it's broken, but we should get it x-rayed just to make sure. Look, I understand what you're going through.
It's not about me.
If you like, I can refer you to someone to talk to.
I was too young to remember when my grandparents... whatever. Except my dad's mum. I kept on thinking she was just going to jump out of the coffin at the funeral and shout surprise, and everyone was just going to laugh.
It must be very difficult.
I sort of wish I had that belief now. But I don't. I don't believe in anything. I am one among 6.5 billion people on this planet. It spins around at 67,000 miles per hour. Around the sun in the center of the solar system. Just one of many in the Milky Way. We are utterly insignificant. Sorry.
Dr. Carter, can I borrow you?
I'm with a patient.
Yeah, I know. The temp, she's still lost. I have got no idea where she is. I've got patients waiting. I'm sorry.
Just a minute.
What are you making there?
Scones.
Could I offer you some advice?
No.
Right. Well, your seal is fine. No blockage in the soap dispenser. It's probably a loose connecting pipe.
Well, I am less concerned with what the problem is and more concerned that you fix it as soon as possible.
Well, it's all going to have to come out.
You expect me to believe that you are going to pull out that washing machine by yourself? Your arms will snap.
I'm deceptively strong for a woman.
A plumber, please. Why?
Well, I was never very good at school and... Mother said I needed a vacation.
What you need is a good shower, a change of clothes, and an elegant coat and blow dry.
You know, my job doesn't make me any less of a woman, but your attitude makes you much less of a lady.
And now, when you say woman, are you one of the...
I'm not a lesbian, if that's what you're asking.
Well, I notice you are not wearing a wedding ring.
I'm single. Just single.
And have you ever thought why that might be?
I'm actually supposed to be meeting someone today. I only took this job because it was on my way home and I need the money. But not this much.
Where are you going? Now, hold on a minute. You should not be so sensitive about this.
Hey, I have paid you to do a job and I expect you to finish it. I have committee members arriving in half an hour. Good morning, Mrs. Foster. Please, wait. I apologize. I am sorry. Huh?
Honestly, I have no idea. We'll jump in a taxi. Yes, we'll pay it out of petty cash. See you shortly. Cherry, you may have observed I am a GP, not a satellite navigation system.
What am I supposed to do? You know that we're stretched. Callum's with Jack. Mrs. Temby's at a church group. I'm not a receptionist.
And neither am I.
Heston! Found it in the kitchen.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Sorry about that. I was going to find you someone to talk to.
I need to go. I'm sorry.
We have to meet in the afternoon because he works nights at the factory and Mother puts the chain on at 9. I can't let him see me looking like this. I haven't been on a date since Timothy Westbrook in 1989. Then I choked on a Milky Way.
This man you are due to meet, you have never actually met?
Yes. No. On the internet. This is our first date. Oh, am I really that embarrassing?
No. No, of course not.
Do you think I'm ugly?
You are a beautiful, articulate, sensitive young woman. That being said, there is never a second chance to make a good first impression. Why don't you come back inside and clean yourself up?
DVD's back.
Right there.
What are you doing? You refused treatment.
They didn't say it'd be too toxic. They offered you a new block and you just refused. Why? Just tell me why.
I don't want to do it anymore.
You're lying.
I've never been a teenager. I've only ever been a kid. I just want to be normal for a bit.
This is such crap. Why are you being so irrational?
Luke, it's not irrational. I've thought about nothing else for the past 3 years. Do you know what it's like to be scared of everything? Scared of dying, who's gonna be there? Scared of there being nothing after, scared of there being something after. Scared of being in a coffin. This isn't irrational, not to me. I wanna do normal things. I can't do that with more chemotherapy.
Then what?
Whatever happens is gonna happen. We know it's terminal. So why does it have to destroy me, us, any more than it already has? This is what I want.
What about me?
You're not even meant to be here. You've got an exam.
I want to be here.
You need to get a life.
I'm not so sure about this.
Oh. Come, let me see.
Oh,
Oh, perfect. You are not going to need these anymore.
I'm not sure it's really me.
When was the last time you went courting precisely? Now, trust me, this is class.
What are you going to do about your washing machine? I haven't got time now, and you won't find a plumber before 2:30.
I can always close the door. Now, go before you are late. I still have preparations to make. Go, 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 go.
We'll both be 16 in a few months. We could go on holiday somewhere. New York, Greece, Benidorm.
With what?
I've got money saved. Benidorm was a joke, by the way.
Who's going to give you insurance? We're 15.
Yeah?
We're only 15.
So?
So we can't vote? We can't smoke? We can't do anything? You can't make this decision on your own.
What are you talking about?
Well, we're not 16, we're still kids. Therefore, it should be the parents' decision whether to consent or withhold medical treatment.
Where are you going?
I'm going to sue your dad.
What are you talking about? Don't be stupid.
It's neglect. We're still kids. You can't make this decision. I'm not going to let you.
It's not as simple as that. Why don't we have a chat in my room?
I don't want to come through. Get your hands off, Pedo.
Have you heard of Gillick competence?
No.
Right, it's a term in medical law to describe when a child can give consent for his own treatment without parental guidance or even knowledge.
So?
William is 15, and as I know him...
Oh, so he is your patient?
He is a very mature and intelligent young man. He would be classed as Gillick competent. It's very unlikely social services would step in.
But he's confused. I can fight that, right? We can go to court. His dad thinks God's gonna save him. We can argue that, can't we?
Luke, why are you doing this? Is it really in William's best interest?
Yes, it is. That's my point. A person is gonna die because nobody's doing anything. My boyfriend's gonna die. How is that even allowed?
I wasn't what he was expecting.
You are obviously better off without him. With your new air of sophistication, you can court a finer class of gentlemen. Now, I wish you all the luck in the world, and you may keep the garments.
I look like Hyacinth Bouquet's illegitimate love child.
You look 1,000 times better than you did earlier.
So why do I feel 1,000,000 times worse?
Why don't you wait in the kitchen just for a moment?
I need to speak to Martin Cardle. Is he here?
No. Who are you?
He's meant to be here for a meeting. They said that the church should be here.
Mr. Cardle phoned about 20 minutes ago. There is an emergency with his son.
What emergency?
I do not know. Can I help?
You did this!
Luke, calm down. It's okay, he's not here. Just calm down.
Where is he?
We don't know. He wouldn't answer my calls. I came home and he'd gone.
Gone where?
Well, I was hoping you'd be able to tell me.
I know he was offered more treatment. You think God's gonna save him? But he's just not.
Where did you get this from? Luke, I know you're hurting. Doing this because you think it's for the best.
Don't patronize me.
Luke, these notes are from the GP. The oncologist provides the doctor with an outline, an overview. Nothing more. They're incomplete.
But he still refused more treatment.
Luke, Will was given the option for another course of chemotherapy. But it was only ever going to buy him months, not years. Months of vomiting and losing his hair all over again. He doesn't want that.
But at least he'll still be here.
Will was diagnosed late. It happens with young people's cancers. The doctors aren't looking for it. They don't expect it. Is it fair? No. Does my heart break every time I think about it? Yes. But it's what he wants, Luke. I love him more than anything on this earth, but I can't force him into a life he doesn't want to live.
Why didn't he just tell me? Talk to me?
Perhaps he tried.
I don't want him to go.
I don't want him to go either. All I know is that Will was diagnosed at an age when your body is changing. Your social life is everything, and you're still trying to figure out who on earth you are. He just wants a bit of normality to experience all of those things.
Mr. Cuddle?
Dr. Carter, thanks for coming.
Any news?
Nothing.
Luke, do you have any ideas where William might be? Any at all?
All done.
Oh, you have taken your clothes out of the bin.
The connecting pipe, as I thought.
So what now?
Nothing. It's fixed.
Thank you very much.
Oh. Self-raising. You didn't use self-raising flour. I tried to tell you earlier.
You did?
Perhaps I'm not completely useless as a woman either.
Oh. You are very welcome to join us.
Do you think you look like a normal teenager now?
So you realize I could see him from here?
Who?
Slapper Carter.
Your dad's waiting at home with a cast of CSI. We're all pretty freaked out. Sorry I broke your Empire State Building. What am I looking at?
Open the email.
You're going to New York? When?
New Year. New Year's Eve. I'll book you a ticket too if you want to come. Knew you'd find me here.
Most normal teenagers spend their days running away from this place.
You still got 15 minutes to make it.
You really think I'm going to go in for exam now?
Well, you've got two choices. You could dye your hair black, become an emo, start listening to Fall Out Boy, or you could go in there and...
Yeah, but what about me?
How Kelly Roach is looking?
I'm serious.
All this running around, threatening to sue my dad. Which I'm totally going to remind you about every day, by the way. Has it helped?
I haven't even revised.
Oh, go and get a C. Go and be completely mediocre and normal and crap. Just go and be it.
Tell me this is significant. I need to know that we are.
You need to stop reading those books.
Please.
What do you think? You made my life everything I wanted to be. You've made me happy. So are we going to New York then?
I'll think about it. And I'll tell you tonight. It's from your dad.
Cherry, it's Heston. I've been looking through my diary and it seems like I've overlooked something because it says give the lovely Miss Malone a call and apologise for being a boring old fart and thank her for being a wonderful colleague and a wonderful friend. To live in memory of the lonesome time. Sing the song, children. Useless to
say. Will's condition deteriorated and he died 7 weeks later. We never did make it to New York, but during those final weeks, he lived and died as a teenager, a fleeting privilege he would cherish, and one I finally understood.
And someday it may happen that a victim must be found.
You don't have any evidence to connect Mr. Keller to the murder of Lauren Porter, do you?
Who have I got today, then?
Oh, Dr. Tyler.
What? He walked on it.
So he just picked up the pillow and shoved it on his face.
Well, tell her that she's lost.
That's enough.
I am more than aware of what my job is.
Then you should be doing it better.